The group made national headlines after hosting a cartoon contest in North Texas. It was an event that offended many Muslims, and it ended in the deaths of two suspected terrorists who opened fire outside. Well, Channel 2 Investigates discovered the American Freedom Defense Initiative has a loyal following here in Houston. Investigator Joel Eisenbaum met with one member, and he's talking with critics who strongly disagree with that member's point of view.
Here we are today, standing up for free speech.
Her get-together in Garland caused a terrorist attack.
Who said shots fired?
At least that's how some people see it.
That's like saying that the rape victim is guilty because she wore a short skirt.
Pamela Geller will tell you her aim with the Prophet Muhammad cartoon contest a few weeks ago was to protect free speech.
We must stand up now.
But this New Yorker, who is Jewish, is polarizing, accused of being anti-Muslim.
Any depiction of the Prophet in our faith is inappropriate.
Geller's American Freedom Defense Initiative, or AFDI, took in nearly $1 million in donations in 2013. And some civil rights organizations have called AFDI a hate group, the same label given to the Ku Klux Klan. On AFDI's website, they sell Prophet Muhammad posters, and Geller makes little effort to hide incendiary speech.
This is a war. I mean, what is everyone suggesting that we do? We lay down our arms, we lay down in submission.
In fact, Channel 2 Investigates has found Pamela Geller has her own soldiers right here in Houston.
We are in a battle to stand for our First Amendment. And to me, that's a battle worth fighting.
The American Freedom Defense Initiative declined to provide us with an exact number of members here in Houston, but we know at least a handful of them attended the Garland event.
I'm here because of the First Amendment.
Including this man, Alexander. He's a Houston AFDI member and has asked us not to reveal his last name.
The idea that it's AFDI is a racist organization is on one hand humorous, I think, and on the other hand, I think it's really false.
Alexander contends he is nonviolent and it's not a specific race or religion he has a problem with. In fact, he says in the oil and gas industry, he works side by side with Muslims. So who does he have a problem with?
Those people who do not believe in the American Constitution and specifically in the First Amendment rights.
And there are those Houstonians who believe the First Amendment is not working. This Muslim imam was quite candid, telling us he believes you shouldn't have the right to disrespect religious leaders.
I think there needs to be maybe a change in the law that nobody should be disrespectful to the spiritually high people.
Of course, plenty of people, not just so-called extremists, would argue it's exactly the First Amendment that allows you to publicly express that point of view. Joel Eisenbaum, KPRC, Channel 2 News.